I had an interesting journey as a Boston Public School student, and I guess I'll date myself and say that I was at the heart of desegregation in the district schools here in Boston. And I was sent to a school that was thought to be a great school. And it perhaps was a great school for white students. But when the black me showed up, it didn't feel great. It didn't feel warm. It didn't feel welcoming. And it almost felt oppressive. When I showed up as principal of the Burke High School, it was like I was in a time machine. Teachers were isolated from colleagues and from opportunities to continue to learn on the job. Students were doing their own thing. It was every man for himself and God for all.
So when I first came to the Burke, I had real dreams of really bringing a lot of collaboration. I have a social work background, and I was trying to bring programs into the Burke, and it was immediately shut down. I came to realize soon that we were really just working as independent islands. We were really kind of just in isolation most of the time, and there was really such a need to really, really join hands and work together, but it wasn't the culture of the school.
We realized that the instruction was just plain and ordinary and built for anybody or nobody.
So it became apparent before even going to turnaround that many of our students, I think it exceeds 80%, have undergone some type of trauma, significant losses, whether it be a parent or friends.
You really can't have a kid in a math class or ELA class who, because they didn't have anything to eat the night before, because one of their relatives were murdered on the street the night before, how can they really focus the next morning if we don't provide some type of support for them to re-engage back in the school?
We were identified by the state as a school that was struggling and in need of improvement. I was hurt by it. I remember crying. And then there was this awakening, because with that new policy came new opportunities. So one of the greatest gifts of the turnaround process was to afford me the opportunity to restaff the school. And so I was able to look at the role of disposition in hiring the right teacher, the right leader, to help us build this community.
For us, it was, you know, teachers, you know, meeting students where they're at, building that relationship, and then bringing on the content.
So I like to say this is a school where everybody knows your name, where we mirror the qualities of a family. This is not the job for just one person, but it's the job for a team.
So the success of the school has been really working together. There's a level of psychological safety within the school, and we're certainly not islands anymore.
We meet weekly, and we look at a problem or practice or an instructional challenge that a student may be having. And then we look at research-based practices, and we try one. And once we try it, we come back together and to see, based on formative assessments that we gave the students, to see if it was successful or not.
One of the things we found in all of the rapidly improving schools is that they have unleashed the power of teacher collaboration. And the only way you do that is for a facilitative leader who is capable of creating the conditions so that her teachers can change the world for their students.
I'm absolutely amazed at this team, and I'm excited. For instance, our attendance went from 83% to we now function between 90 and 92% average daily attendance each year. Our graduation rate started at 34%. Oh my goodness, I say. And it's now at 74%.
When you see how far students have grown when they walked in the building and the opportunities that they see themselves in when they leave this building, it's just so touching that in a short amount of time that we can really change lives.
So don't be alone in it. Be distributive in your practice and build the community of leaders that are at school with you to be greater than they were before you met them. Your job, your responsibility, your role is to educate, teach, and love every child that you see as if they're your own. And I have children, and I love them. And these children, as long as they're here, they're mine, and I love them as well.